Raytheon, in partnership with Northrop Grumman Corporation, has secured a follow-on contract from the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, DARPA, to advance air-breathing hypersonic systems. This agreement will enable the development and flight testing of additional Hypersonic Air-breathing Weapon Concept (HAWC) vehicles, offering expanded capabilities and enhanced system validation. This is a crucial development. In this video, Defense Updates reports on Raytheon and Northrop Grumman getting additional contract for hypersonic weapons development. Let's get into the details.
We are active on Twitter. Follow us there for real-time updates. Link in description section.
Weapons that exceed the speed of Mach 5, that is 5 times the speed of sound, are called hypersonic weapons. Hypersonic weapons are being persuaded by several advanced militaries since their speed and ability to fly in unpredictable paths make them almost impossible to defend against with the most current air defense systems. There are several ways of developing hypersonic weapons. The first is through the use of ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missile. As the name suggests, this kind of missile is ballistic in nature, but is launched from the air, unlike traditional ballistic missiles, which are launched from land or sea-based platforms. The second is using HGV, or hypersonic glide vehicle. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using a ballistic missile where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier and glides back to the Earth towards its intended target, attaining hypersonic speed. The third is using a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engines can power flights to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missiles to reach hypersonic speeds. The scramjet engine can power a hypersonic cruise missile. HAWC uses this approach. Raytheon and Northrop Grumman have been strategic partners since 2013 and formalized their collaboration in 2019 to jointly develop, produce, and integrate Northrop Grumman's scramjet engines into Raytheon's air-breathing hypersonic weapons. Lockheed Martin was the other participant. The first successful flight was in September 2021. Further testing was carried out in mid-March 2022, but was kept secret at the time to avoid the impression of escalation against Russia during the Russian invasion of Ukraine. The existence of the test was revealed in early April 2022. On the 18th of July 2022, the third successful flight test of the HAWC was reported by DARPA. This vehicle flew faster than Mach 5. The HAWC program reached a crucial point with Lockheed Martin's design passing the final flight test in January 2023. The flight tests of several operational prototype systems for the HAWC have successfully validated the digital engineering concepts used for the designs. Principal Director for Hypersonics, Mike White, stated that HAWC would be smaller than hypersonic glide vehicles and could therefore launch from a wider range of platforms. White additionally noted that HAWC could integrate seekers more easily. Technology developed for the HAWC demonstrator has influenced the design of the Hypersonic Attack Cruise Missile (HACM), a U.S. Air Force program of record, to create a scramjet-powered hypersonic missile it could deploy as an operational weapon. The advancements will directly benefit HACM, as the airframe and engine designs are closely aligned. The range of the missile will be 560 kilometers or 350 miles. Colin Whelan, president of advanced technology for Raytheon, said, "We applied learnings from each successful HAWC flight test to ensure that it's the most sophisticated system of its kind. Continuing this important program will expand our knowledge of hypersonic flight and allow us to deliver the crucial capability our warfighters need." Dan Olson, General Manager and Vice President of Weapons Systems for Northrop Grumman, said the HAWC follow-on contract serves as an engine pathfinder program in our new production-ready hypersonics capability center in Elkton, Maryland. Our factory of the future will seamlessly transition our validated propulsion system design into an operational-ready system to support further flight testing. Russia has already fielded Avangard and Kinzhal, whereas China has deployed DFZF and YJ-21. Kinzhal has actually been used in the Ukraine-Russia conflict. For some time, the American military was undecided when it comes to developing and deploying hypersonic weapons. This led to the U.S. military lagging in this technology. But there is consensus now, and as stated by U.S. DoD leaders, hypersonic weapons are a national imperative. Michael E. White, Principal Director for Hypersonics, had said that the adversaries have increasingly focused on systems that dramatically compress the timelines and the time scale of a tactical battlefield. He indicated that the American portfolio of subsonic and supersonic weapons will be found wanting in a battle. He had stated that the U.S. Department of Defense has developed the hypersonics modernization strategy that accelerates the development and delivery of transformational warfighting capabilities based on hypersonic systems. It seems things are finally progressing in the correct direction.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.